Exciting. Well, a little bit about these two. Hou Yingchao at the top of the screen with the rat tail in the back, rocking the expressive hairdo, is a short pips chopper and would say he was the initiator of short pips chopping in China. No one else on the Chinese national team did it before him. He wanted to be able to attack more. His service immediately getting the point on Wang Wei. Wang Wei, the defender, also short pips, who beat Kenji Matsudaira, the top seed, who many expected to take this with ease. But if you've seen the US Open before, you know that we have some strong players who've left China, come here to coach and practice. So Wang Wei ties it up now with the serve. Two choppers, always interesting to watch. Now in the modern attacking, or the modern defensive game, we see a lot of forehand attack, very strong attack. And even the short pips game, I mean, Yuto Muramatsu, a few others that have such big attacks on both sides, not afraid to come in. Hou Yingchao with his hooking side spin forehand is a thrill to watch.
Yeah, now with these two defenders playing, it's a struggle. A, if the game goes on too long, it might turn into the expedite system, which we have seen a lot in the past. And it's a challenge for both of them to really get the points. The best attacker would emerge victorious, I believe.
Right, the expedite system, if 18 points have not been played within 10 minutes of active play, they will send out a counter to announce every time a ball is returned. And if the receiver returns 13 balls, the receiver wins the point. So it puts pressure on the server to make sure they don't get too defensive. I don't think either of these players are going to have any problem attacking before the 13th receive. And a service warning here. Ball straight up. The ball needs to be tossed nearly vertically. Wang Wei trying to get a little advantage by tossing it back to create more spin. Both players are having trouble with the opening chops. Very interesting. Now, just so you know, for USATT ratings, Wang Wei, coming from New Jersey, is rated 2752. His highest world ranking was 78. He was the former number one in Spain. And his highest rating in USATT was 2815. He was actually a former Hunan provincial team member. On the other side, Hou Yingchao, I'll tell you a bit more about in a moment. So Hou Yingchao played for the Chinese national team from 1998 through 2013. He played in the French League in 2009, had 3 years in the Russian League, was the Chinese national champion in the year 2000. Some big names didn't show up that year, as he admitted gladly, but still a very difficult competition to come out on top of. In 2006 and 2014 and 15, played for the Austrian club in the Champions League with Schlager and some others. I guess in 2006 with Schlager.
Wow, so a lot of international experience for him.
This is really where we see him most. He's Champions League, you know, he's a father to a three-year-old daughter, a 10-month-old son. His wife is not a table tennis player, she's a dancer. And he's just playing in the Champions League. That's pretty much, you can see his highlights in the Champions League on YouTube. I wouldn't be surprised to see a roller and around the net shot, some hooking forehands throughout.
Wow, and
wow, look at this power, so much on that forehand. He's a big guy too. Both of these players are quite tall as defenders.
Now, do you think, what rubber is he using on his forehand? It's the typical Chinese rubber that was, you know, the sound?
It sounds like it. I didn't get a look at the racket and I didn't ask him. That would be typical. And by the sound, I know yesterday we discovered Xing Hong Wei using pips on the backhand side just by, well, I guess the trajectory as well and the change of pace, but the sound was quite different. Both players with such huge strokes on the forehand side, very fast racket speed. So it should be a bit of confidence for Wang Wei as he's leading here by 3 points, having taken out the top seed Kenji Matsudaira.
And that's surprising. We have not seen a lot of long rallies. Both of them are attacking pretty early in each point.
Absolutely. This is part of the reason it's unlikely we will see the expedite rule. I think the rallies will get a little bit longer as they start to figure out each other's games. Hou Yingchao with a cautious block at the back of the table after the opening forehand spin shot. So third towel break of the game, in case you're newer to table tennis. Every 6 points, the players are allowed to towel off. But any more frequently than that used to be a problem, slowing down the game too much. It's always interesting to see how the sport's developing. New rules they're coming up with, things to keep it moving. Wouldn't be surprised if they introduce many balls into play as well. so many game points. That's three in a row, and he tried. He spun it short on the table. And this is a very smart tactic against a defender if you can do it. A slower, spinny shot forces them to play the ball from lower near the ground, often popping the ball up for you to kill on the next shot. One more game point for Wang Wei. Oh, he thought he had it right into the body on the crossover point, but with the short pips, Hou Yingchao brings it right back into play. And look at this, four game points saved, Neha.
Big one for Wang Wei right now. Huge pressure on him at the moment, I believe.
The momentum definitely on the side of Hou Yingchao. He was standing up straight in the backcourt, Hou Yingchao. Not sure if he thought it was coming down, but it was right at the baseline of the table. Watch the replay here. Smart plays with the soft touch to bring Wang Wei right back into the table. Big step around, almost turns his back to the table there. The fishing shot kicking way away from the net as they do. And look at Hou Yingchao's body language. Just a little bit relaxed. Now game point to Hou Yingchao. It's five in a row that he saved. Not this time. Inside out forehand. Too much power from Wang Wei.
So nice to see the way they're controlling the spins from their opponents.
Yeah, I think they're going to get longer and longer, the rallies, as they start to understand the shots. Players who are from the same national team sometimes you see playing longer rallies. They're more familiar with each other's games. But out here, I think they're still sort of testing the waters, figuring each other out a little bit.
Warming up.
So Wang Wei here, another game point. Can't take it on his fifth attempt from 10-6. And again at 12-11. You can see the head shakes, the body language. We're at the fourth towel break. It's the only score possible. 12-all, third deuce point. Now just so you know, Hou Yingchao, 36 years old. Earlier this year, Wang Wei, 32. Wouldn't be surprised if he still is. The ball does tend to carry here in the thin altitude in Vegas. Lobbing and fishing. Often the ball will go long, but I think both of these players have had enough matches so far to settle in. Wang Wei with his sixth game point. And there it is. He takes it 14-12 in game one. This is a best of seven match. And if they go like this, we're going to be here a while. But where would you rather be than watching such a close, exciting chopper, modern chopper, attacker battle out here?
Now, Adam, I've been thinking both of them are pretty, you know, experienced. Hou Yingchao, 36 years of age. Wang Wei, 32. Does that affect their movements? They have played against younger opponents in the past, but emerged victorious. It's pretty interesting to see that.
Yeah, it's always interesting to see the test of youth versus experience. The youth, obviously, they're going to be a bit faster, maybe more fearless, but wisdom, you know, table tennis is such an intelligent sport. It's very physical and it's very mental. So that's why you see some smart players. Karakosovic, for example, is not the youngest and fittest, but he's still destroying a lot of young, strong players. And Hou Yingchao just the same in Champions League. Look at that power there. Even though it goes long, you can see in the body language, a bit disappointed. Such a huge forehand stroke. It's a short side of the table, and Hou Yingchao, he's dangerous at the table. It's part of the reason I think we've seen Wang Wei looking to be aggressive so often. Beautiful receive. That's the shovel serve that I love, the modern Chinese serve where you come around the outside of the ball. Sometimes you contact it just on the top half, barely, with a little top inside. Other times, heavy under, anything in between. That's a break for Wang Wei. The ball sits in near the net. Hou Yingchao has the opportunity for the angles there.
Now with the choppers, you know, just a slight change in the angle when they're contacting with the ball, it changes, totally changes the trajectory and the spin in the ball and makes it so hard for the opponent to analyze it. Wang Wei doing a brilliant, you know, job in that.
Absolutely. I was going to say also short pips. This is part of the reason that Hou Yingchao decided to play short pips despite all choppers for the Chinese national team using long pips in his day when he started. Because, one, he wanted to be able to attack, but two, the control that gives you that ability to attack also gives you the ability to vary the spin. So on this first towel break, Neha played in the Beijing Olympics for India, 2008, played on the Indian national team for many years, has been blogging and writing outstanding pieces to promote table tennis, and yeah, it's good to be working with you, Neha.
Thank you, Adam. It's an honor to be here, to be working for USA Table Tennis and ITTF at the same time.
That's right. Top edge of the racket, played well, right into the middle. This is going to be a strategy. We see, oh, Hou Yingchao's got the American flag next to his name. All right. Maybe he's moving here. Huge forehand once again. That stroke is so long. It's part of the reason he's not afraid to take the ball from near the ground. This is where you see those hooking forehands when he gets into the fishing game in the Champions League.
And that was some strategy you would see generally for an attacking player. You know, a defender would generally serve and go back on the table.
Now again, even as a defender, you're right, you're going to see a defender farther from the table. They're still going to want to stay close as often as possible. Any opportunity to attack is going to make them more dangerous. I think they're more likely to finish a point, win a point with an attack shot. It's pretty much what the modern defense has become. I think that's an exciting thing to bring some variety to the game. Now, I saw a lot of questions earlier online about the wiping the hand on the table. Why do they do it? To wipe the palm, to get it clean of sweat so they're dry for gripping the racket. And they do it near the net so it's unlikely to wet the table where the ball might bounce. That ball hits Hou Yingchao. Once it touches the shirt or anything that's not below the wrist, between the wrist and the fingertips or the racket, point is over. It's that attack right down the middle again.
Middle is a very dangerous place to attack because it's so hard to suddenly shovel your feet and then move and take, you know, have a wingspan and make that movement.
Right. It definitely causes some hesitation and indecision. You know, if you hit it wide to either side, the player knows exactly where to go, which side of the racket to use. But if you can force them to decide right on that crossover point, even if they get the ball back, it's going to be a weaker shot and set up your next ball. These players are thinking about shots in the future, not winning the point outright. But he does right here with a heavy top side spin serve from the backhand. Now, one other thing about the pips players, you'll often see them twiddle the racket to use the inverted rubber when they serve, so they have more spin, more control. See how he twiddled? He turned the racket around, the inverted black side on the serve. Beautiful angle, way wide to the backhand, and both of these players have such wingspan, but they've been playing a lot of shots wide, testing each other.
And you bought twiddling, you know, it's so hard. When I was a long pips player, mm-hmm. and I would also twiddle, and it's, you know, you keep training just to learn how to twiddle in between the points. It's pretty hard.
Yeah, it's amazing to watch. I think for me, Tatiana Bilenko of Ukraine, just amazing, the magic twiddler. Wow, that angle again. Every time he hits the ball, not only does he hit it so hard, but he adds a little side spin coming around the outside of the ball to bend it out of reach for Wang Wei. It's going to force Wang Wei to not only stay in a little closer to the table, but keep his shot deeper on the table and probably look for the opportunity to attack. He did take game one with a lot of attacking shots. Warned again for the service. Service fault. It's his second warning. Tossed back.
Oh, that's a fault.
He was warned earlier in the game.
Now, talking about the psychological aspect of this, you know,
right.
It could hurt him. It could also, you know, motivate him to come back stronger.
You know, the crowd always tends to support the person who got called and faulted because usually they feel that it's unfair. You know, the umpire is doing it. It's the assistant umpire doing his job. He's got to keep it fair so neither player has an advantage. But still, the crowd will get behind Wang Wei. But crowd or no crowd, Hou Yingchao's attack on the forehand side earns him 2 game points here, the third towel break of the game. By the way, the warning was in the first game. I know I said this game, I meant this match. But yeah, the second warning, that's, you know, umpires don't even have to give a warning.
Uh-huh.
Typically they do. They like to, they're not trying to interfere with the game, but if it's a blatant foul, they can just call the fault. One game point saved. Last game it was the other way around. Wang Wei with 10-6, lost 5 in a row. And now he's the one chasing. Trying to stay cool out there, keep the hand dry. Heavy topspin deep on the table and he ties it up. We're back at deuce. Can't ask for a better first 2 games than this.
This match is getting as exciting as it can get.
Now you talked about the psychological aspects. Of course, the distraction of being faulted. It's very easy to lose your focus. I've seen it happen. Hugo Calderano earlier this year against Kenta Matsudaira. Actually, just about a month and a half ago. Mm-hmm. But Wang Wei keeps his focus, comes all the way back 3 points in a row to earn a game point with the short side of the table. Step around attack. See how close to the table he's staying. You can see he's looking for the opportunity. Turns, knows he's going to get a ball back that's a little bit soft and takes advantage. Beautiful shot inside out this time. That wrist is so flexible from Hou Yingchao. This is something that comes with experience. I mean, this creative play is very bold. Hou Yingchao now earning a game point in the push. Tried to introduce a little bit of side spin in the rally. The serve was interesting. Little kicking top side spin serve, trying to earn the third ball attack. Again, that's how Wang Wei is going to win his points more often than not. Look at that, all the way in distance. Stamped the passport on this point. What an amazing job of traveling from deep. He saves this one. It looks like the point's over for sure. And the touch here, the soft one, almost comes down for a second bounce on the table. Hou Yingchao has to keep his focus there to win that point, and he does. He takes the game to tie it up 13-11. Look at the scores.
Wow, this is one close game. 12-14, 13-11, 1-1 tied.
So they're dead even on 25 points so far. It'll be interesting to see how it develops. Wang Wei has shown us his attacking game is very strong. Hou Yingchao unpredictable with where he's going to go. We haven't seen him. I feel like we haven't seen the long rallies that we would expect just yet.
I was just about to say that. We haven't seen a lot of long rallies. Just justifies the fact that despite being defenders, they are such good at attacking.
Right.
Yeah, and they're totally adopting the right strategy because the one which attacks better will be able to emerge victorious here.
Now we can recall a few times that Hou Yingchao's hit the ball hard and hit it off the top of the net. You know, I also think that defenders, when they attack in general, they're not trying to get into a counter-looping rally. They're hitting to finish the point. It's a little different mentality than most attackers. Obviously, attackers want to win the point, but they don't mind attacking a few shots in a row if they have to. Again, that is their game.
So much power from the core.
Right, when we talk about what's needed, leg strength, lower back, abs, core as you talk about. It's so difficult to drop the ball and keep it short. A lot of people, when someone lobs, they ask, why don't you just dink it? Why don't you just touch it back softly so it sits on the table for a few bounces? Not so simple to do. Give it a try. See what happens. Just watch the pros.
I know. And for table tennis, what appears is, you know, not as what you experience it. It's so hard with the spins.
And spin here is what wins the point. A bit of side spin from Wang Wei carries the next ball off the table. Now both players using sponge under their short pips, which means they can attack a little bit more. Ball sits on the rubber a little bit longer, a little more control. And this is again on the backhand side. Table tennis players all around watching. Again, 146 tables have been active throughout this week here at the US Open, a very unique tournament. So fans having their chance to see this live. Now the first towel break of the game, I think it's a good time just to let you know that Wang Wei beat Guillermo Munoz in the opening round, four straight games after that against Anthony Tran. And then after that, beat Li Jian following that. And that was the first time he had lost a game, actually, to Li Jian. Following that, he beat Kenji Matsudaira, and here he is against former Chinese national champion and team member for a long time before leaving. Floating chop.
So we're also live on Facebook here, and we have a question. Is it possible to do wiggle-wiggle with long pips in your estimate, Aka the snake?
We'll talk about it. So Willie Leparulo, president of National Collegiate Table Tennis Association, is a lobber. And I call it the snake, he calls it the wiggle wiggle, where you, from under the table, hit a little bit of side spin on the ball and then move up in some different direction so that it confuses the receiver, whoever's taking the next shot, to where the ball is going to go. I mean, you can't control as much. I guess you can do the wiggle wiggle, the snake. You're just not going to be as able to control the spin. You're really dealing with what's coming in. So you'd have to contact it quickly. It's very rare to see anyone try it just because you're not gripping the ball and reversing the spin as much. Not even close. So yeah, send in those questions. And you can feel the rallies are going to get a little bit longer. Watching sort of the body language and the positioning of Hou Yingchao. Both players looking for the opportunity. Even the push right here. Looks like it's sitting up a bit, but it's still deep on the table. Once again, it's Wang Wei, the slightly younger, slightly more energetic, who's making the attacks count. We're dead even in points and games. Look at that, right into the body again. Middle of the table all day long if he can do it.
Deadly attack there.
My favorite points with Hou Yingchao are the ones where he gets far from the table and hits those hooking side spin forehands, but we haven't seen that yet. If this ball comes down, we might start to, although I think Wang Wei might play the short side of the table. Again, the forehand's been pretty dangerous from Hou Yingchao, much like a lobber. Nice to keep him pinned in the backhand court. But defenders, I guess it really depends. If you're having trouble against their chops, sometimes you might prefer the attacking game and the counter looping game. Hou Yingchao's forehand's just so heavy, so loaded with spin.
Yeah, and he wants to take his forehand. Even when Wang Wei is pushing it deep into the backhand, he's shoveling his feet well, moving, turning around, and making a forehand. So making very good use of his strength.
So Hou Yingchao steps into the lead here. That's a break. A little up on the table. Sits a little high, but it's deep. The spin variation, we talked about it earlier. The short pips allow you more variation, and both of these players know it well, but they're still not used to facing short pips choppers. It is a relatively rare style in the game, far more common to play attackers.
And even though chopper versus chopper is very rare that we see.
Especially in the men's game. There's several top women in the world who are chopping. The style seems to be a little bit more effective. It's rare in the men's game. I think Ju Se-hyuk playing the final at the World Championships in 2003. But Schlager was able to take it. It's the last non-Chinese world champion we've seen. Ooh, look at this lob, comes down. Hooking side spin, there it is. Three in a row. Oh, and finally a shot finds the net. This is the first point where we got to see what Hou Yingchao does more uniquely than anybody, so successfully. And it all started with the save. That's the long stroking arm. Look at this. Right up near the barrier.
Yeah, that side spin, you know.
Yeah, has to contact the side of the ball, makes it hook. It's great. And now 3 game points for Hou Yingchao to step into the lead, 2 games to 1 over Wang Wei. Right on the body, that's what happens when you try to drop it back. Odds are almost always against you. Every once in a while, you see someone keep it on the table, but even if they do, it usually comes long, doesn't finish the point, just gives the attacker or the person who brought the ball back a chance to come back into the table. In this case, that's Wang Wei.
And because both of them are choppers, they would automatically be adapted to, you know, be ready for those balls.
Right, they're used to running back into the table looking for the opportunity. Short side of the table, sneaky shot. For a 36-year-old to turn like that on the ball, that is impressive play from Hou Yingchao.
Definitely a big risk at that point, and gutsy play by Hou Yingchao.
See the way he pulls in there, pulls the racket right up to the forehead and turns the waist just a bit. Seemed like the obvious choice would have been the safe choice, in quotes, to go cross court, the length of the table, a little more margin for error.
And he didn't turn way too much. It was a quick movement.
Right.
Rather, he contacted the ball on top of when it bounced, right on top. So that was the right timing.
Yeah, very smart, subtle play. Quick move from Hou Yingchao to take the lead. Now, just so you know, who Hou Yingchao beat to get here. Started off in the first round playing Kaiki Matsushita. 4-0. After that, beat Thomas Kynath. Several-time U.S. Open champion of the past, Thomas Kynath. Playing for Slovenia, very impressive player, very creative to watch. But that was a 4-0 victory with the chopper on screen. After that, it was Satoshi Aida, who's also a chopper. Actually, a chopper with inverted rubber on both sides, which, as you and I were talking about, is extremely rare. And in the last decade, I think Paul Drinkhall's wife, Joanna.
I played against her a couple of times. It was very deceptive.
Trying to pull the Hou Yingchao game point from last game, but a heavy chop. Again, if you haven't played chops this level, it's just amazing how difficult it is to attack it and still get it over the net. It takes so much strength out of the legs and timing.
And mentally, there's so much, you need to have so much patience. It's they keep returning. So more than physical, I feel against a chopper, you need to be mentally very strong.
Absolutely. The tactical game against defenders, as you mentioned, patience. When Hou Yingchao's making that shot, again, it's just bold play that finishes the point pretty quickly. After he beat Aida, he beat Yuki Hirano earlier today to make it here to this match against Wang Wei. So now you know the history of this tournament for these two. Backhand rip, that's what short pips are for. A defender who doesn't need to twiddle. Look at that rip of a shot. And the side spin from under the table that Hou Yingchao uses on the forehand. You can watch the ball kick right here. And he's fooled. You could see how much he had to reach at the last moment. Keeps the side spin on the backhand chop and comes in to win the point. Fishing game doesn't work both ways here. Now again, I just want to mention, as a defensive player, someone who plays a lot of fishing and lobbing, the ball is carrying here in the thin altitude or the high altitude, the thin air. So the ball travels quite quickly, and also the tables are top notch. They grip every ball. So with the topspin, actually, there's just a lot of grip. So if it's topspin, it's going to kick away from the net more than usual. A little bit of backspin goes a long way here to stay in near the net. And that ball right there seemed a little bit shorter on the bounce, right?
And as it touched the ground, it went back. So you saw there was so much of backspin in that.
Well placed. Again, that loose wrist just opens up the wrist and hits it behind Wang Wei. Fools him a little bit, hitting it out of reach.
I'm seeing in this game, more than power, it's the placement that both the players are focusing on, and it's getting them points.
Yeah, placement is a huge factor. Again, you practice so many hours a week for so many years. You know how to hit the ball hard. This time a little bit of side spin as well. One nice thing about side spin as a defender is it forces the attacker to sort of calibrate and try to judge how much underspin is on the ball. It's not as easy to read. is a straight backspin chop. Very awkward, uncomfortable shot, a slow spinny ball by Hou Yingchao leaving. And you see he's not happy with the decision. Wang Wei to try and play that ball back with touch.
Yeah, he tried to kind of do that side spin.
Right. Very awkward ball. Maybe if you put it back up with topspin deep on the table, at least it keeps you in the rally. Look at this placement again, right into the body. Well, if you're ever going to have a service error, when you're up 9-2 is not a bad time. Not quite a 10-0 mercy point, but you could tell he's frustrated.
I agree, but 11 points, table tennis game. I mean, at no point you can afford to lose such points. So you need to be focused at every single point.
Right, and just in case we have any viewers who are a little bit newer to table tennis, missing a serve is quite common because the pressure to make it so low to the net and so specific on the table. Look at it again, right into the body. Both players using the strategy well, the step around, big forehand strokes. Just long, Hou Yingchao. From under the table, he puts a little bit of side spin on it sometimes, and sometimes just straight top spin. So if Wang Wei is expecting it to kick, it could still hit him in the body and be just as effective. A little off the top of the net, the apology, but a dominant game for Hou Yingchao. Goes up 3-1 over Wang Wei.
Now what is that so special he did in this, is this game? It's 11-4 for Hou Yingchao. I believe those attacks in the middle and with those side spin, top spins wide onto the forehand court really made a difference.
Right, I feel like mixing up the game. You know, table tennis, if at this level especially, but breaking patterns, people recognize patterns quickly, they learn from their mistakes. You hit a heavy chop once, you know, or a heavy underspin serve, you rarely see the exact same serve twice because people learn so quickly from their mistakes, or at least the points that they lose. Hou Yingchao varying his game so much, the placement of his deep pushes, his attacks, his fishing shots, as you mentioned, we saw more of that this game than we have the whole match.
And we thought the points are getting longer and longer, but they have been attacking so well that it's not the case.
Well, we did have some long rallies as well, though. Overall, still shorter than usual for defensive players. Oh, very ambitious shot, but even with short pips, it's going to be tough running in that far to catch the ball after it's dropped a little bit and still make the shot to the short side of the table nonetheless. A little off the top of the net again, but right into the body. This is one of the most, it's tough to do. It's as a competitor on your way up, trying to attack the ball right into the body, you really just want to play it safe and go wide, go to the length of the table. Try hitting it at your opponent's body. Watch how effective it is.
And just to execute that, you know, you need to see the position of your opponent very precise and then attempt it.
And we've got a timeout here. Wang Wei, this is a few shots in a row that, not greedy, I would say ambitious. He's just sort of really looking for his attack, but also decision making. We talked about that a lot yesterday, that table tennis, when you know how to play so well as these guys do with all their experience and years of training, choosing the time to take the right shot, especially as a defender who can attack. So Wang Wei, I think, is going to have to earn himself a little bit higher percentage attacks here, hang in closer to the table if he can, because he's coming in from so far and the ball's already dropped.
Absolutely, and with 36 years of age and 32 years of age, both of them have good experience. So pretty good match, packed stadium here in Las Vegas. Treat for definitely for all the US table tennis enthusiasts here.
That's one way to do it. And again, it's not how much spin is on it, but how deceptive it is, how difficult it is for the receiver to read. Hou Yingchao thought there was more top spin on that serve than there was. The hooking side topspin shots. It's funny, for both of these, you feel like the players are very comfortable attacking, but at the same time, Hou Yingchao, who seemed a little bit more experienced in that game, a little bit more power on it as well. It's very interesting to imagine the confidence level, if you could measure it, of both of these players. Hou Yingchao obviously leading here by two games, is one game away from moving on to the men's singles final, which would be a thrill to see. We're definitely going to have a chopper in the final. The question is, who's it going to be, Wang Wei or Hou Yingchao? Getting back into that fishing game, Neha. Well, didn't last him very long there anyway. Again, the ball sails here. It's your natural inclination when you're fishing or lobbing to keep it deep on the table, drive the opponent away from the net, not give them much of an angle, put more pressure on them to make the attack. This is not the first time we've seen Wang Wei. You know, both players have deceived each other with the amounts of backspin on their chops. I think the ones that we see from Hou Yingchao just feel like they're bolder shots. He's hitting it really hard right at the table, not working as hard with the legs. And on Wang Wei's side, it's a very physical step around. So fast.
Seems he was always ready for all those attacking shots that he gets an opportunity to. Clearly separates him.
Soft touch, that's a little bit of backspin that keeps it in near the net. See from this angle some of the fans here, the table tennis players from around the hall. Again, this is the men's singles semifinal. And props right there to Hou Yingchao for not trying to take the attack and force it after making that brilliant chop from down low. As hard as it was hit right into the body, he covers the middle. And it's tough. You've got the taller you are, the bigger your middle is. So it's tougher to cover that elbow turning point right there, the hinge.
Now Wang Wei is mostly doing his backhand serve rather than a forehand. Gives him time to be in a good position after that.
A good position for defense, but oftentimes you'll see players who step around a little bit, serving more from the backhand corner, sometimes even a pendulum serve, as Hou Yingchao, at least he's in position to do. It sets him up for the attack. Sounded like you cracked the ball, hits it so hard trying to go to the short side of the table. That's another very tempting thing to do against the defender. The ball's hit very high. You think I can hit through it. This one's loaded with spin and he overcompensates, hitting it too long. You just start to put yourself in their shoes and wonder, man, you feel like your options are running out for Wang Wei, right? He's tried many things in the attacking game, his placement, his pushes, getting in with the chops, just trying to move it around. But Hou Yingchao's been the stronger player throughout the match, especially since game three.
Definitely a big puzzle for Wang Wei to solve.
The second time we've seen a fishing point end quickly at the first attempt by Hou Yingchao to bring it back with topspin. So just to clarify, when he wipes the table there, he's most likely wiping sweat that had dripped off his face on the table. If he wipes it near the net, he's wiping the sweat from the palm of his hand, rather than drying sweat already on the table. Hear how flat that sounds, the hard rubber. Sounds like Chinese rubber to me. And a lot of people ask, if people are jealous of the Chinese rubber, why don't they just use it? But many Europeans grow up training with non-Chinese rubber, which is a very different stroke. You're carrying different weight. You have to contact the ball quite differently. We got a timeout here on the side of Hou Yingchao. Now looking to the corner, I don't see any coaches sitting in seats. This is what happens when you're playing well into your 30s and you've played either for a provincial team or the Chinese national team. Sometimes, you know, Samsonov almost never has a coach in the corner. You'll see him just go sit there and come back with a brilliant plan.
Yeah, I mean, when you have so much experience, you just know during a timeout, all you need to do is regain your composure and think through. Hou Yingchao. Now, I think he was too aggressive with his forehand topspins in the last 2-3 points.
It's interesting. You know, he's fished a few long as well. Sometimes you have to remember what got you where you are. When the score changes, the mentality changes for some players. But once again, we don't know exactly what these two are thinking, but we do know that their experience, that's what's gotten them this far. And just as you said, a very ambitious, aggressive attempt near the table, but the heavy chop of Wang Wei ties it up. This is his chance, and now he's got two serves. That was a big point as far as morale and momentum. Calls the timeout, wants to get that first point to feel like the timeout was worth it. And a deceptive serve again. It looks like there's more topspin on it than there was. And Wang Wei now with the game point was way behind in several points in a row. Let's see what he pulls out here. And the safer, spinnier opening shot, instead of going for a rip kill, just spins it with pressure on the table, follows up again 11-9, and Hou Yingchao clearly in trouble. Hands in the air out there.
Wow, such brilliant. Now, we spoke about mental maturity yesterday a lot, and I think Wang Wei displayed it brilliantly in this game, trailing and then coming back to win this game 11-9.
Yeah, very impressive play from the younger of the two experienced players, the 32-year-old. So I'm very curious to see, you know, watching Hou Yingchao play live. He played at the LA Open, played against Samsonov at the final earlier this year. Samsonov, despite having a difficult time against Yuto Muramatsu just recently at the World Tour Grand Finals, a very confident player against choppers. But Hou Yingchao in the Champions League has beaten many world top players. You know, Hou Yingchao said his world ranking at his best was number 9 in the world.
Wow, that's a big, big accomplishment.
To be in the top 10, very few. Cheng Yiqing, who was here, but very few can do that. Trying the middle of the table again. Now, while it is a wise shot to play if you can make it, it's also the least forgiving. Smallest margin for error from the middle of the table. It's the shortest distance.
Looks like he has some problem with his shoulder.
Which wouldn't surprise me with that long stroke and the heavy forehand rubber. And 36 years of being alive. Table tennis, we mentioned yesterday, Neha, you had mentioned since the ball got bigger, it's more physically demanding. And we do notice the physiques of the top players today quite different. I mean, this came up from 40 millimeters and before that, 38.
Definitely, you need more physical strength now with the new ball. The size was increased, and then the material, it became plastic. More physical strength and makes it hard for players of older age, more experienced players, to maintain that physical ability to compete amongst the best in the world.
Right, touch will never be unappreciated. It will always be to your advantage to have touch. But we don't see as many players playing the way that Karakasevich does, that Waldner did, and a lot of the old-timers who are less known for just incredible power. Now this starts to get really interesting. Momentum, you know, 11-4 for Hou Yingchao in game four, a dominant game. Has a big lead in the next one, maybe 9-5. Loses the game 11-9 after the timeout at 9-8.
He's definitely extremely pressurized at this moment because he's been leading and then he's been losing those games. So needs to pull up his socks probably in this set.
So the first towel break of the game, and the player that's behind, Wang Wei, is leading by two. Beautiful shot, opens the shoulders to mislead and then hits it inside out, lets the arm drag behind. Now on both occasions, just think to yourself, Hou Yingchao blocked the ball instead of attacking when it was fished back, as strong as his attack was. How did it really benefit him in the point? It kept him in the point, but it didn't win the point for him. The finishing shot was just very impressive, and it brought Wang Wei back into the table. One nice thing you can do against a defender, often with an open-faced push against a heavy chop, just leave it on the table, force them to come back in, and then you know exactly how much spin is on the ball, or a much better sense of it. And also they have less time to react and cover your attack, cover their space.
And that's what both the players have grown in the last two games, is that they have, instead of being bold and aggressive, they are more safer and trying to be more precise with better positions on the table. And now we're seeing more longer rallies.
Oh, after all those hooking side spin forehands, I thought for sure Hou Yingchao was going to take out a barrier, maybe even run into the assistant umpire. If it were the other way around, it was Wang Wei who got the fault. Wouldn't be surprised if he'd accidentally knocked into the towel box. The court is quite big, but at the same time, these players as defenders and world-class players are going to take up a lot of space as well, and some rallies might send them through a barrier. So 4 points in a row for Hou Yingchao. Talked about momentum. This is a really important time for Wang Wei to sort of grab the steering wheel again and drive. That looks like the Masato Shiono forehand. The racket head up high, throws it back, keeps the topspin on deep on the table. Adds a little up pressure to Hou Yingchao. Wasn't able to handle the spin so well. We've got the Japanese players right in front of us. Heard Masato Shiono and quickly turned around. A little break there, a little fortune for Hou Yingchao.
A nice style break to think through the strategy for Wang Wei.
So if you're watching live right now, don't be afraid to send in your questions. Happy to address them. Inside out forehand attempted. He's a bit far from the table on that and a little bit late. It's going to be a difficult shot.
I'm probably a bit overambitious at this point.
Right. How many times has he fooled Hou Yingchao? I think it's the third I can remember, maybe fourth in this match, with that the light spin serve that looks like topspin but isn't. It's mostly side. Again, we talked about the bite on the table. With heavy backspin in near the net, it's just tough. The ball's going to stay closer to the net. Hou Yingchao then has the obstacle of the table to try and get that full stroke over.
Absolutely, and there's such less time to react to that point because the ball suddenly, you know, stands up and drops down.
Very ambitious attempt again. Short side of the table with the inside-out forehand, and we're tied up. This could be a seven-gamer. It's tough to imagine a match more exciting than the Adriana Diaz match from earlier. But let's see, who knows? So heavy, the bottom of the net, it sounded like it hit his own side of the table before the net. I think a little bit of self-coaching there, saying don't keep hitting it into the chop. Leave it back on the table, start over, reset the clock. The clock being the spin of the ball in that metaphor. There's some power, and he's moving his feet quickly, trying to stay the aggressor. This is how Wang Wei started off in game one, winning so many points. And throughout the match, his attack, I think he's just been working harder to have a more typical attacking game on the forehand side.
Just cannot get better. 3-2, 9-9.
I guess 3-3, 9-9, right? Let's see. And we might be there. It's a game point from trailing. He was down many points on several occasions throughout most of this game. The momentum has changed. He was up 4-2. Deep on the table, it goes long, and we're going to a game seven, a deciding seventh game Again, a game decided by only 2 points. Look at this. The scores say right there. So tied up at 3 games each. Whoever wins this next one will be moving on to play for the U.S. Open title.
This is amazing gameplay by Wang Wei, especially trailing 1-3 and then making it 3-3 in the semifinals. Wow. What maturity and experience that he's shown in the last 2 games.
So impressive right now. You know, Hou Yingchao last year was here at the U.S. Open and was expected to be in the final. We had Adrian Crișan from Romania, who's beaten Timo Boll many times. I think has a winning record maybe against Timo Boll, but either way, it's a very close one. And Hou Yingchao got beaten early on by a relatively unknown Japanese player. It was deuce in game 7. So we'll see. He's made it much farther this time around to be on a TV table here in the semifinal, but he's got one more game to win first.
Definitely is pumped up to make his mark this time at the U.S. Open.
So a quality chop low and deep on the table from Wang Wei. Makes an uncomfortable inside-out attack opportunity for Hou Yingchao. I was just going to say how impressed I was with the patience and the spin that we see from Wang Wei. Takes it a little softer, plays the spinny, consistent shot, but was fooled with that floating chop. And the height on the table, too. Hou Yingchao's balls are coming back a little bit high, but they were deep enough to still be problem. Be a problem, rather. I don't know, Neha, this one could go either way.
I can feel their heartbeats because mine is way high right now.
It's pretty crazy. Your hearts are connected. You can feel their heartbeats with your heart. You're all plugged into the same power source. Nice variety of the placement on the table, earning that third ball. Well, not third, much later ball attack, but the step around forehand, rather. I think Wang Wei's right to get that attack. He's just really got to pay attention to the spin on the ball so closely because Hou Yingchao has been varying it so well. Now, we talk about world-class players playing against relatively no-name players on the international scene. Wang Wei playing quite well at the YOLA Teams Tournament over Thanksgiving weekend, Washington, D.C. Had a few big names there. Jorg Roscoff was there. Well placed in the middle, and the power, it goes right past him. Hou Yingchao not even able to get a racket on the ball at all.
Absolutely. Wang Wei probably gained his composure, thought to himself, choose the right ball to attack, and that's exactly what he did, which earned him the point.
Such focused play. It's 2 in a row from Wang Wei to make it a 1-point game, and he's got a serve here to tie it up. We saw the hesitation on 2 occasions. It looked like he was going to step around and take the forehand attack, but he pushed it back. And even the serve, you might recall, he's gotten a lot dumped back into the net on that backhand, what appears to be a heavy topspin serve. This time it clipped the top of the net for Hou Yingchao.
Such a tricky situation for both the players. Now both of them are getting into longer rallies, and the one who chooses the right ball to attack is getting the point. So very tricky situation for both to really get that right bounce and then go for the big ones.
Right, and as Hou Yingchao clears the table, between sweat and when you wipe it like that, you just want to make sure there are no particles of rubber left on the table, anything that might affect the bounce of the ball on your side. which would definitely be to your disadvantage. You're going to have to receive that funny bounce, the funky hop. So interesting to me, again, with the shot selection, it's you've got a loaded cannon, Hou Yingchao with that attack. And what do you do if you know someone's going to go big? Keeping it deep on the table, keeping it low, these are good ways to make sure their percentages stay low. Surprised, but again, the ball that high, he goes right back into the body down the middle. It's very difficult for Wang Wei. You and I both looked at each other after those grunting pushes.
Exactly. He's grunting on the push. And, you know, you mean he's, like, trying to do something special on those with those grunts?
Possible. Maybe he's putting a little more effort in, trying to get more spin on his pushes. Just so unusual to hear on a push. Forehand topspin, and the fishing shot comes back long. Wang Wei keeping it close, a one-point game.
See how the game has progressed from both the players trying to attack in the third or the fifth ball to now going into more pushes and then choosing the right ball to attack.
Service placement fools him. Instead of going to the forehand, goes deep to the backhand. We talked about unpredictability. This is the value of being able to serve long from time to time. You know, about 80% of the serves you see at the professional level are half long, meaning the receiver can't tell if it's going to bounce on the table, on their half of the table, a second time, or if it'll come off the table, allowing them to attack. Tends to force hesitation. I think they're going to play a let. That's interesting. Hou Yingchao thought it hit the shirt. It was very close. I think they have to we'll see. Well, now that's very interesting because they awarded the points to Wang Wei, but Hou Yingchao's shot was the last one to make it, if I remember correctly.
That's correct.
That's why Wang Wei has to not stop playing. The umpire has to be the one to stop the point. Wow, this is interesting. Gotta love some table tennis controversy.
This is a lot of drama happening here right now.
So they will replay. I think that's the right decision. I think the umpire making a great call, very diplomatic.
And great call from Wang Wei to not...
not to ask for the point, not to say, no, buddy.
Exactly.
You stopped the point when you shouldn't have. No, this is good, fair sportsmanship from everybody.
That's the game of table tennis we love.
Just long. The fishing game has been so strong, and that's what started the whole controversy, the fishing shot covering the middle. The ball hit right into the body, but Hou Yingchao now with a big point.
Ending it off with an inside out.
Beautiful shot, short side of the table. He turns on it. We remember when Hou Yingchao did it to win the game. Look at this, 7-7 in game seven. Could be 9-9, who knows? Seems to be going that way. An ambitious shot once again, straight down the center of the table from where he is, instead of going for the distance on the loop.
Good strategy, though. Attempted it right, but probably the contact was too early.
Right. The idea is great. It's a difficult shot. You know, you can't really criticize the guy. He's been making a lot of big shots this way. His percentages have gone down. That's a smart serve there to the backhand side deep. Tries to play the short side of the table again. You know, the first time he went for the attack, he really kept some extra spin. He put some extra spin on the ball to give him some insurance that the ball would come down on the table.
Hou Yingchao does not have a timeout anymore. He used it in the last game.
So we'll see what he does here, down two with two serves. Top of the net and out. Look at this. Match point for Wang Wei, who took out Kenji Matsudaira and is looking at taking down a former national team member from China. He's got three match points. Top of the net, a little help there. Hou Yingchao saves one match point at the third towel break of the game. This gets very interesting. We talk about mental toughness and focus. Wang Wei with the last two serves. This is why when you have the chance at the beginning, you and I both give away the serve. We say we would like to receive if we win the toss. So you can have the last two serves of the match if it goes the full distance. At least two serves in combination. Oh, beautiful ball. It bites the table and stays at the back edge. Hou Yingchao, no contact. And what a performance, a pat on the back. Wang Wei takes it after a controversial ball there late in the match. And a slight smile of relief. It looks like old friends, but it's Wang Wei who moves on to play the men's singles final.
Amazing display by Wang Wei, trailing 1-3 and then making his way to win the match. Men's singles semifinal here at the US Open in Las Vegas.